Howdy y'all, and welcome back to Ark Survival Evolved with me, your host, the Butcher Man. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you love it, hit that subscribe button. You know you want to. You gotta give me some love. Alright, let's get to it. I got an egg sitting over here, so maybe at some point during this video, we will kind of get to that. See if that works out, or if we just simply kill a bird. I don't know. I think we got like three more. We got like three more sitting in the fridge. I got a whole bunch of meat jerky. So I need to do that. Whoop. Wrong one. There we go. And I got a bunch of poop in my inventory. If you guys see that. Bunch of poop. Last episode we built a greenhouse. Right? Well, come the greenhouse, you're going to do plants. You're going to do all that. Which I end up working out. The crop plot situation, and we'll go take a look at that. I'll pick up all this poop, but yeah, but now they got dung beetles instead of fertilizer bins or whatever. But this is what I got set up now. It's four large and four medium, which seem to work because the largest won't go next to each other. But I end up going out and kind of messing around. Oops, you got a duck, but it's okay. Messing around, and I got two of these at the same time. I got two dung beetles. I should have recorded it, but I wasn't really planning on getting one. I was just kind of going to go out and mess around and see what they're doing, blah, 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 you know. But I actually ended up bringing both of them back at the same time. Like, I tamed this one because I wanted it, and it was like a level 60-something when I tamed it. And if you walk up to it, you can pick it up. Well, you can pick it up like that, and basically you throw it. It's like a Dimorphodon. You pick it up and you throw it. But I picked it up, and then I'm just like, well, if I can carry this, why don't I tame the other one that was in the cave, the real low level, like a 12, I think it was, and pick it up with the bird, and then we'll just bring them both back. So we did. But I want more. I want, like, probably four or five of these things, something like that. But we got to think of names for them. We want a certain number, and I have an idea, but I don't know. That's why I'm collecting more poop, is so that, you know, we can go out and maybe tame more of them this episode. I don't know. We need a Fiomia, though. It's the thing. And a little bit ago, I was out here gathering materials and stuff. And I was going to build, like, set up our boat for taming a mammoth again, which I'll end up doing that at some point. I just haven't got around to it. But I was out here gathering wood, and I seen a Fiomia. Let's see if he's still out here. It was like a level 8, I think, out here. Huh. I don't see him now, so the Dilos probably ran him off, to be honest. There was a bunch of Dilos out here. They're over there now, but... Man, I should have tranked him right then. I wanted to do some of this stuff on video, though. I hate doing so much off video sometimes. And like I said, I didn't mean to do the whole... dung beetle thing off video, but I got to messing around. Oh, there's a Fiomia right there. Let's see what level he is. Dilos are gonna mess with me, though. 36. That's not too bad. There's another one up here. Let's go check it right quick. There's a couple of them. This is the one I seen, I think. No? That's a 32. I'd like to have a low level, because it'd be super, super easy. But I guess one of these wouldn't be too bad. What's up with you? Can I get you to just go kind of run down the hill there? Maybe? Will you run away from me? There you go. Yeah. Come on. If I run, maybe I can like lead him? Ah, perfect. Perfect. That could not have worked out any better. That's amazing. That was totally not planning, but it works. And I tamed another parasaur, but apparently it got killed. Some carno showed up and decided to have a snack on it because it was next to the wall. Where did you go? There you are, buddy. Come here, man. Come on, get knocked out. Oh, I'm shooting at the wrong arrows, aren't I? My bad. Whoops. Well, we don't need any kind of taming effectiveness, so that's, you know, whatever. As long as it doesn't die, then, you know, that's a thing. Well, you know, it happens. All we really need him for is poop. Shoot him in his butt. Come on, man. Right in the bum. Let's go, bro. Get knocked out. Get knocked out now that I'm shooting with the right arrows. Come on, dude. I don't know how many arrows this thing would take. Hopefully, it shouldn't take that many, I wouldn't think. There you go. Right on, man. I have berries? I have berries, but not the right berries. I want to get the right berries for our special friend that I tried to kill. I wonder why his health looked like it was going down so fast. You know? Let's see. I think I have magic berries on one of the birds. Lady Luck? No. Oh, there's one. Maybe Shadowwing? There we go. 74 should do it. You shouldn't really need that many for this little Fiomia. There you go, buddy. Eat up. Wow. That's a really small training bar. Maybe I'll need more? I don't know. He's like oinking like a pig. But anyway, I think this episode might end up being this, because it looks like it's going to... looks like it's going to incubate out. So that's going to be our episode today. Is we'll go ahead and give him another half one of these. Put that away so it stops reloading. But yeah, we'll just give him this, and then we should be able to just leave him out here, and he should be good. I don't know if I guys showed you guys this, but I actually filled this thing completely. And then I was wondering how long it lasts, and then I looked it up, and it says it lasts for like 33 days if you completely fill it. So we're good for like a month. Really need to stop collecting poop. I got a lot of poop and like nowhere to put it, because the weight on the dung beetles is fairly low. But we need more dung beetles, and I got to decide how many we want, but... I'm gonna cut for a bit, and then right when this thing's about to hatch, I think I'll come back, and then that'll be, you know, that's what we're gonna do this whole thing, is trying to tame this, raise this Argentavis. Alright, y'all. We're back, and it looks like it's about to finish up. I've been sitting here staring at it for a bit, because I didn't want to get busy, like, doing stuff around the house and then miss it. Because it ain't something you want to miss. Your first baby. I have about 80 something meat, I think, in my inventory. I don't know how much it takes. No idea. Come on, little Argy. I don't know if we'll hatch all of them, because like we'll get one a day. I don't know if we need that many Argies. Oh, little baby Argy. Imprint. Maturation process. Do you need meat? You do, don't you? Imprinting 0, raised by Butcherman, sample, bunch of numbers. Is he gonna eat? It eats meat, doesn't it? Yeah, there it goes. I was gonna say, I'm like, I'm pretty sure it eats meat. I mean, it's an RG. Come on, little buddy. Or is it a guy or a girl? Oh, it's a female. Lady Luck's daughter. We're gonna have it follow us over here. I wanna get into this corner over here. That way it has, cause the feeding trough is outside. Oh man, that'd be so cool if you could like pick it up and like walk with it, because it's so small, such a tiny little baby. It sounds like it has adult footprints though, footsteps. We just simply need to get it like over here by the door, just to where it's, but you know, close enough to the feeding trough. I don't necessarily need to get it outside. Probably be better if it's not outside. Come on, little baby bird. This is actually really cool. I don't know how the imprinting thing works. I've been trying to read up on it, but I'm still just not really sure. Do you need more food by chance? Not really. Oh, you can hold 16 now. Wow. Your weight's going up fast, man. Or chick. I don't know. Female. Alright. Okay, so it should be in range. Because they are, and it's farther than that. So we're going to go ahead and turn off wandering. For sure. And then do that. Okay, yeah, I'm not sure how the imprinting thing works. So, you know, we'll just have to kind of, I don't know, keep up with it. What do we got here? Cycle neutral. I don't know. How much are you holding now? We need to, like, keep it fed, that's for sure. We don't want to lose our face baby. Let's see. Stats. One, let's see, 1825 health. Not too bad. That's probably about what both of its parents had. 2400 stamina, 6000 food, 532 weight, 290 melee. Yeah, it pretty much looked just like both of these whenever they, you know, it's kind of an average between the both of them. I think with the imprinting though, you get like perks. I think. I think that's how it works. You get like bonus perks if it imprints on you, like a certain percentage or something. But I think this looks like it's probably going to take a long time. So once it hits juvenile, it'll feed out of the feeding trough. But and then once that happens, then I think we can leave. I can leave and go get dung beetles. But if you guys have noticed, I named them, the first two I've gotten, I've named them John Lennon and Paul McCartney. Which, if you guys aren't familiar with that, that's the name of the actual Beatles. Like the Beatles, the band Beatles, from like the 70s. But I looked it up and I found out there were six Beatles in the band. I don't think they're all like as popular. So if we get another one, it'll be Ringo Starr and then so on and so forth. We'll probably have, we might only get three, because they actually produce fertilizer fairly quickly, like surprisingly fast. But we gotta think of a name for our little baby. See, look at that. I was just up here a little bit ago. Pump some weight. I've just been pumping weight. That's all we got is weight. You're like overburdened. I need to take one off of you. You're overburdened too, aren't you? A little bit. We'll go ahead and do that. I'm going to be here for a while, so I'll just keep track of them. But yeah, right here we got rock carrot, citronel, long grass, and Sava Root, and all the mediums I have Narco Berries. I have Narco Berry seeds. I haven't put any fertilizer in there yet. And another thing I have is the greenhouse effect is only 285. I swear I looked in, I seen it in somebody's video that it was like 300. I mean, maybe I'm off a little bit, or I wonder if it had something to do with the slope roofs, or, you know, maybe if they were flat roofs, it would give you 300 instead of 285, but it's not really that big of a deal. I was just, you know, I seen it and I was kind of wondering, you know, if there was something I did wrong or, because I know the floor doesn't need to be, a greenhouse floor. So I'm not really sure what the deal is, but it's a level 159. I can't remember what the, the parents were when they tamed out. But I'm gonna cut for a bit and then I'll be back and we'll decide what we're doing once it reaches juvenile. Alright guys, there's not a lot that's happened. I've been gathering some materials and stuff, and a Carno attacked. Well, then the birds got stirred up, and I walked in, and this is what I see. The baby bird's laying on the ground, and his mother's just standing right there staring at him. Like, standing over it, protecting him. You know, protecting him from the world. I don't know how long this is going to take. This is probably going to take, like, all day. It says it wants care in 2 hours and 36 minutes. So, by the time you guys see me next, I'll probably be off doing something else. I need to build the taming boat to go get a mammoth, which I've started getting the materials and stuff for it, so we're on our way to doing that. What is that light? It's weird. But we're on our way to doing that, and then I also want to get a couple more dung beetles. They're producing pretty good, but you know, more is better, always. So yeah, we'll get to doing that, and then I just figured I'd give you guys an update and tell you how it's going, and you know, so you guys can keep track of it as well. But yeah, I'll see you guys in probably just a second. Well, everybody, we are currently winging our way toward the upper south cave, I think is where I went last time. So we're going to go check that out. Our new Argy baby is now a juvenile and is eating out of the trough. And I filled the trough, so that should get us for, you know, a while. So we'll kind of see. Are those tame? Those look like they're probably tame for sure. I do want a Quetzal at some point, but it'll probably be like a long time before we end up getting one. Just because, you know, it's going to be a lot of planting, a lot of food, a lot of narcotics. Which, in the garden now, in the greenhouse, we have 2 medium crop pots with narco berries, so that should start producing pretty good. They are now all fruitlings. We just had a server update to 243.3, I think. It's a fix for the frogs or something like that. I was wondering yesterday when I went to the swamp to gather cementing paste to make the greenhouse. It's just like, man, it seems like there's nothing here, you know? It seems like all the animals are gone. All I could find was snakes and a pair of ceratheriums. But yeah, apparently they had messed up the frog spawn and probably some other things, but they got it fixed, I think. But our admin on this server just said that they're already planning for a 243.4. So apparently there's something else that they broke. Let me see. Should be getting close. Yeah, it's just down here. And it's going to take me a little bit to load into the cave, you know, as always. So once I get in there and start flying around and probably have to kill all the bats and all that stuff, then I'll bring you guys back and we'll kind of check it out and see if we can't find some more, a couple more dung beetles for our collection. Alright, y'all. So we're in the cave, and I've already got a level 8 dung beetle right there against the wall behind that snake. And then I think there's another one down there on the floor. It doesn't really matter what level they are. I mean, dung beetles are dung beetles, right? They level up pretty quick, and then you just sit there and pump weight the whole time. But there are tons of bats in here, as you can see. So we're going to try our best to kill them. If we can. We'll go and aggro all of them, just because. We just gotta make sure to watch Lady Luck's health. Make sure she ain't, like, getting too damaged. But I found, like, this is pretty much the only way I can find to kill them, is to fly back and forth and kind of do with it then what you do with a Meganora. There's 2 of them down. There's 4 of them down. Come on, y'all. She's not taking too much damage. I was kind of worried about it, because it's like there's so many of them. You know, even if they're only hitting you a little bit, if there's so many of them, then, you know, it can do quite a bit of damage. But we are going to try to tame that one, like, right next to the entrance there. Because it'd be fairly easy, I think. Come on, Snakey. Come on. Wish I could just pick it up. Come on, I don't want to hit you. The snake not gonna help me or what? Huh. Need to put some of my cold weather gear on. I did bring it, because it gets cold in the cave. I don't know what's going on with this snake. He must be stuck on that beetle. I'm gonna put you on passive. I don't want you like taking off if I go to start like fighting this snake. Yeah, he's stuck. We can just get rid of that. And then throw the meat in here. We don't need it. Put a piece of dung in our slot. Is there one down there? Did I look? There's one down there. What level is it? Another level 8. Like I said, it's not really that important what level it is. We'll feed it. I wish we could just fly down there and pick that one up, because it'd be so much easier. If we could pick it up and like bring it up here and put it up here somewhere. I don't want to fall off there, especially since I've taken my parachute out of my slot. I did start wearing parachutes because I've been having a lot of trouble with falling off my bird. But you can see there are more bats down there. Yesterday when I came in here, I actually went down there and like the two beetles were both in the bottom down there. But they don't seem to move around a lot. Like if you're just standing behind them like this, it's actually pretty nice. They just like sit there. They just sit and wait. Waiting to be tamed, I guess. But I brought a bunch of manure in case I found a high level. Whoops. As I say that, he like gets aggro. Maybe if I go down in the bottom and kill all this stuff. By the time I get done messing around down here, he'll un-aggro. There's a dung beetle in the mess. My bad. That's kind of bad. I didn't kill him though. But that's good. He's aggroed at me though. He's fairly peeved off at the moment. Go away, dung beetle. Come here, spider. I do need to eat everything, like, take everything, like, eat everything down here. Where'd the snake go? There he is. Where'd the dung beetle go? Is he in bad shape? Did I kill him? I might have killed him. I didn't think I did. I might have. Let's see if this guy is still peeved at us. Or did he jump down there too? I didn't even think about that. Did I kill both of them? I might have killed both of them. What is that? Is that all bats? Kinda looks like there's something over there. Yeah, just a rock. No, it's just a rock. Bats. Scorpion. Yeah, he must have jumped down or something and I might have killed him. You guys will know. I can check the footage back and see if I killed him, but I might have. That's not a huge deal. We'll just look around a bit more and I'll see if I can find some more. Alright, so currently I have one beetle tame and the other one I'm kinda waiting for the aggro to die. Because their aggro is just crazy long. Like you fly all the way up here. You got Ringo Starr there. That was one of the level 8s, you know, the level 8 that survived. And there's a level 12 that I aggroed and it fell down here. Let's see. Looks like he's lost aggro. That's good. I'm gonna have a little bit of trouble with these spiders though. I'm gonna go ahead and kill them. We'll just get rid of them, that way they're not a problem. And you gotta like harvest them or whatever. That way the beetle doesn't try to get them. Alright, little buddy. Oh, another spider, I think. Nope, scorpion. Come here, buddy. If I wasn't trying to get two dung beetles, I might consider getting, you know, taking a scorpion or something like that, but... I mean, really? We're in the cave for a dung beetle. Sneaky, sneaky. Oh man, that's halfway. So a level 12, around about the teens or whatever, you can do it with two. I did that level 8 with two. And then you just gotta wait. Sneaky, sneaky. This one's gonna be named George Harrison. I don't know how many of these guys were famous in the Beatles band, but I looked it up and it gave me six names. So we may end up having six Beatles, just for the fun of it, you know. I try to read chat from time to time because, like, when the server crashed, I always debated whether it crashed or if it just got restarted or whatever. But like the admin Lovitigo said the server's restarting because it was updating. So if I hadn't known that, I'd have just been out doing whatever. So as much as I don't like the chat being in the video, there's not really anything I can do about it. If I turn it off, then I'm going to miss like announcements and stuff like that, because the admin seems to do announcements. Because like right now, he said he's not even here. Like, he's not playing. He's at work. And he's doing it through some app or something like that, some program. So he can't actually make like admin announcements, I don't think, or whatever. I don't know. It's better if it's on, though. But now we'll have four dung beetles. And we'll probably come back every so often or whatever, and then if we find like high level ones, then we'll tame them and trade them out for the low level ones, or we'll just have like an entire herd of dung beetles. And you know, I don't know, maybe I'll create a public chest, or I'll use fertilizer to trade with or something. But I'm sure now that dung beetles are out, people have tons of fertilizer probably, because they'll be doing the same thing I'm doing, just taming a bunch of beetles and just filling them with poop. But that Fiomia I got, I put him on the roof. I think I named him Bernard or something like that. But he's doing a pretty good job. He's actually producing enough poop that I can just go up there every so often and grab some. And he's actually on my poop storage device too, because I just put it in his inventory. Oh wait, I'm sitting there waiting for him to get hungry, but it's just like... Don't yell at me, guys. I don't know these things sometimes. Alright, let's see. You're not following. Go ahead and change your name to George Harrison. Whoop. Which, I don't know who that is. I've heard of John Lennon, Paul McCartney, and Ringo Starr. That's why I said I don't know how famous the other ones are. But this is what I did yesterday. As I picked it up, I get on my bird. You can see the dung beetles there in my hand. And then on our way out, we'll grab Ringo Starr. And then we just fly back to base, just like this, carrying two dung beetles. So I'm wondering if you could do this same thing with a Mesopithecus. Where was that exit? Was it up here? Maybe? I can't remember where the exit is. I thought it was right here. I'm just like flying in circles now. I don't know. I'll find it, and then I'll get back to base, and then I'll bring you guys back. I found it. Never mind. Yeah. What am I got it on? There we go. Alright. So now we're good to go. We are good. Let's see. Which way are we going? There's the red one. We'll head toward... I think it's like the center of those mountains is the way I gotta head. Well, yeah, I got two dung beetles. This will make four for us. I might do one more trip and get six, but it depends. If these four produce enough fertilizer for us, then that's fine. The two I've already got have already produced, like, lots. Lots and lots, so... but the idea is, if I have four of them, and I fill them up before I log off, the next day when I log on, they should have about enough to fill all the garden or whatever. But, yeah, like I said, I'll bring you guys back once I get back to base. Well, everybody out there, I made it back. Made it back to base. Got Bernard here making poop. Got all four of my dung beetles just walking around on the roof. This is actually a pretty nice design. This wasn't the plan for it, but the fact that I have a wall up here is pretty nice. I can have any animal I want up here just wandering. They can't go anywhere, but I got all four of them, and they're all just, you know, chugging along and hanging out, and they're going to make me some nice fertilizer and some oil. But our garden is definitely picked up. I mean, look at this. I mean, it looks awesome in here. We got fruitlings. 15. I mean, everything's producing right now, which was super fast. I don't know if it was the fact that the server restarted or what, but... I think their server restarted and, like, moved forward maybe a little bit. So, pretty soon we're going to have, like, all the fruits we want. So then, as long as we get enough eggs, we can start making plenty of kibble. Start making kibble. I need some raptor eggs, really. I need to go raid somebody's base or something for raptor eggs. I might ask them here in a little bit if anybody's got raptor eggs. But our juvenile Argentavis is about, probably, what? 10 to 15% done, 20% done, something like that. I don't know. It's going pretty good, though. It hasn't eaten a whole lot, which I don't know how much they do eat, but if we try hatching the other eggs, we might try hatching... maybe it has eaten a whole lot. It only holds stacks of 10, maybe? I don't know. Oops. We'll leave that in there. Somebody will eat it. It holds stacks of 20. Why are these only stacks of 10? That's weird. Huh. Oh well. It works. But yeah, that's going to be it for today, guys. If you enjoyed the episode, hit the like button. Hit the subscribe button. You know you guys want to. I produce fantastic content on the Butcher Man channel. But that is going to be it for today, guys. Stopping in, you know, thank you for stopping in and watching Ark Survival Evolved with me, your host, the Butcher Man. Have a nice day.